be a good idea to go ahead and talk about our costumes. We'll go ahead and start with Alan Pickler here. He's Deadpool. Why do you costume?
For me, it's more about just having fun, entertaining. How I got into it was all it started as kind of a joke, a dare, so to speak, and caught the bug. And my main reason is most of it is just to entertain people, have fun, you know, be lighthearted. Making kids happy and stuff. So, the biggest thing I do is volunteer, like going around different places and stuff. But, have fun with the kids, make them happy, especially if it's hospitals, adults with wounded warriors, adults and stuff like that, sick kids and children with wounded warriors, veterans, just try to do some of that stuff and just get out there and just try to make people laugh. Can put a smile on their face.
Do you do a lot of pre-built costumes, or do you make your own, or do you just buy one and start costumes?
For me right now, as a beginner, all I've done is just put together a pop costume, an expensive demo one, but I do parodies. So typically, we'll try to make a fun version of demo in some capacity. So do a mashup of different characters. One here I did, floated in the local area, came up with a hockey game, which was the Mighty Duck Pool. I've done some stuff where, doctors have cups that just go to hospitals, talk to Duck Pool, deep pool, run around, just being silly with the kids and stuff, and adults in the hospital. I have some ideas for some future ones. So it's just like doing parodies, and just kind of being a little silly. So I'm not the typical Deadpool, cowboy, grab a sword, specs, and everything. I do sometimes be doing some Comic Con, but other than that, it's just making real lighthearted and character.
Yeah, I think we really got into it.
Two.
We just took a vacation in town at the convention some pop stuff for the closet. I'm just making some scraps. This is all wood. I've swung this against the sport cones. I think this one actually bumps the lady in the head on that. I apologize for using it. It held up pretty good. The biggest thing is just trying to build this stuff so it'll survive a fall or a drop or the occasional drunken stupor. This one, this looks like a bingo helmet. This was a made of helmet. I just customized it. I just cut it to slits for the lobster plate. And again, I got some golden armor. This is a lobster plate, so I'll do a special order for his smack day. Pick that up. I did all the paint job. I'm black. I painted the base coat of green. And I added that. Or I'm going to go ahead and do it. This was actually back and forth, maybe a flat. It's pretty durable. Not heavy. The biggest pain on this stuff, you can see the jagged edges a little bit. I've sanded it down, but it's a labor of love because you had to cut it, you had to trim it, you had to sand it, you had to file it. And it feels try some nylon spandex mixed webbing next time. This I think I got from TN Webbing, which is a local company. They sell on the internet. They're pretty good folks. The buckles I get from Buckle Guy, you know, all over the place. This was put out by John Mao and our Aliens Legacy group. Little motion tractor. It's going all over the place because the compass is in with all the wires. What's happening is it's picking up all the spray, the electrical fields, even though it's DC. Still picking up the small interference from that. The compasses are generally fairly sensitive to any sort of magnetic metal or electrical field. Even with DC, there's still a very small field, but nowhere near as big as alternating current in AC. This is an actual cast resin unit. This was made by Nikon Props. I just resined everything together, sanded everything down, resined it together, sewed it together, and made it work. And it was actually cast with natural sections. It turned out okay. The only thing I did was I did this custom battery motor. And I just painted. This is a PK cell 2200 amp hour battery. I just painted it black with acrylic. And it matches pretty good. The actual movie, they use blue lights. Use the color called brown best. It's actually brown. Because it's blue light, it looked all brown and it's like, you went to go film it. It's all sorts of way running some math and lights and how they interact with the lights. But since it's Aliens Day, let's cover some other stuff they've done. They've done crossover, Superman and Aliens. The other main cosplay I do is Joker. This is one of the origins. And he was, and in all of them, Batman literally creates his own worst enemy. But of all the irony, the guy falls in a vat of antipsychotic drugs. That's what changes his color, his face. But the guy was already pretty stark before Batman got him. And this is basically where he has a psychotic break. Just about all of the different remakes that they do with this, he always has a psychotic break once he first sees his face. This is another crossover they do, Batman vs. Predator. It's actually pretty good. I mean, you know, Batman would probably be the most awesome prey for a Predator. And since he won't kill the Predator, he basically told him, he fights dirty, he's dishonorable, you deal with him. So they killed him, the Predator. Well, you know, being hunters by nature, they're pretty vengeful, so in one of the later issues, a different one comes back to seek revenge against them. I mean, it's beautiful, aren't Batman always has a tool and a toy for any problem. this is a book that came out last year. It's supposed to be a whole VR thing. I guess, okay. And Dark Horse puts out these omnibus books, which is a compilation of all the different books. Compilation of five or six different comics in one about volume. Dark Horse does these releases once they finish the series after a while. Another way they can make them get their sales. The only problem is the store keeps getting a little bit big after a while. As a side note, Dark Horse is doing some new Predator volumes, especially the Ryan's movie coming out this year. These are armor templates put out by New Man Matt and Predatorian, formerly the Hunter's Lair. That's a website that's written by Art Andrews. There's a lot of folks who got a lot of information here. But he made these nice little JPEGs, 100% with that perfect template. And then you can cut them out on leather. Everyone knows what this is. I'll put holes in your belt. I like to use a Chicago screw, and I just use a big washer. It spreads the pressure out so it's not so likely to tear right through. There's going to be a heck of a lot more resistance if it tries to tear a hole through. Now, the nice thing about Chicago screws is it's got this smooth outer shaft. And it just screws in. Use that on this, it works pretty well. But I'm redoing the whole costume leather for the armor pieces because of durability. The sealed foam, once I treat it with resin, becomes very good. I've already had it crack up in a few places. And that's just going to keep on happening over time. The other, now if I use regular craft foam, the problem with it is the different glues you use will end up coming apart if it gets too wet, it gets too hot, whatever. And there's not really a good in-between. You got to deal with one issue or the other. The predominant issue with leather is leather's expensive, but leather will last forever. And even if you get it all nasty and moldy, it'll still, you can still reprocess it and get a good back as new, good as new. That's pretty much all I got in this episode.
What do you like about that?
I make it you wear. This is a Predator costume I'm working on. This is a backpack. This mounts on a backpack unit that I got. I'm still waiting to get some more parts so I can get this finished now. But it's just a general wood unit. This is actually pretty close to what it looks like in the comic. Yeah, I use the comic books for reference material, because they'll give you a good idea of color and what you can get away with and what you can't. Okay, this isn't a better one. One of the other ones I had some good shots, but you know, there's all sorts of good material you can use to make your own costume based on comic books. And the colors are a lot more forgiving because of the way they have to do the process. Because they'll typically do a rotoscreen, which is basically, it's a frame and it's a screen and you push one color to it. And you do that, you know, three times, you got a three screen, you know, three color process, and that's what gives you a lot of fun once you're all working together. It's some very neat stuff, but it lends itself well to mastered art. That's what we used to do with CDs and DVDs when we worked in Ally. It's a pretty cool process. There wasn't a whole lot of waste, but